Hello, welcome. In today's video, I'll be demonstrating the performance boost provided by the new Turnip drivers for Android. In my case, I experienced a performance gain of up to 35% when using Yuzu in some games. Others remained unchanged, and only in Super Mario Odyssey did I get a better result with the old driver. This new driver version is compatible with the Adreno 600 and 700 series. But before we see how the driver performs in practice, make sure to hit the like button to support our content. If you're not subscribed to the channel, consider subscribing to get the latest updates on your YouTube timeline.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
First and foremost, I recommend that everyone use this driver from now on, regardless of whether you're using Yuzu, Citra, or Dolphin. You'll experience significantly better performance with the Revision 12 driver. I'm impressed with the difference each of these revisions brings, indicating that the drivers available for Android gaming are still in the early stages of development. Another crucial point to mention is that upon entering the page, you'll encounter three versions of drivers. The first is labeled regular. Use this version only if you want to use the most up-to-date video drivers, but you probably won't have any significant performance gains. Now, let's get to what really matters, the drivers labeled aggressive. We'll have two options, aggressive and aggressive beta extensions. By using either of these two drivers, there's already a performance improvement, especially noticeable if you're using processors predating the Snapdragon 8 Gen 2. Therefore, the aggressive will already provide an FPS boost in games. However, the standout is the aggressive beta extensions. I recommend using it in almost all cases, unless there's a bug that wasn't present in a previous driver. In tests I conducted with this driver, I even managed to run Zelda Breath of the Wild in docked mode, and at times, the game reached 30 FPS, which was previously impossible. I also finally achieved 30 FPS in Zelda Tears of the Kingdom in handheld mode. Of course, I can't maintain a constant 30 FPS, but previously, my maximum FPS rarely exceeded 22 FPS. I selected a few games to test between the old driver, Revision 11, compared to the new driver, Revision 12, with the improvements we'll see below. It's worth noting that not all games had their performance improved, as mentioned earlier. Let's start with Bayonetta 2. In docked mode, I still can't maintain the game at 60 FPS all the time, with occasional drops. However, with the previous driver, the game rarely reached 60 FPS. After the switch to the new driver, I can already maintain the ideal speed in a few moments. Comparing the two drivers, I observed a 25% performance difference with the new driver.
Yes, sir.
The recently released Batman Arkham Asylum has received criticism as another poor Warner port. On my device, I can run it in handheld mode at 30 FPS. I decided to test it in docked mode to check the performance with the new drivers, but it's still far from reaching 30 FPS. In this case, the gain just from the driver change was almost 38%. Bowser's Fury is another game I can keep stable in handheld mode but not in docked mode. In tests with the new driver, there was an improvement in some moments, and in others, the performance remained the same compared to the old driver, resulting in a gain of about 23%. Ninja Gaiden 3 is another game with a very unstable FPS. I don't know if it's the Switch port itself, or if the app still can't handle the game properly. Overall, the FPS has a wide variation, but if we consider the maximum FPS between the two drivers, we can say that the driver with the new revision achieved almost a 40% better result than the Revision 11 driver. To my surprise, it's now possible to reach 30 FPS in Zelda Breath of the Wild in docked mode. The reason is not only the driver improvement, but also the excellent work that the Yuzu development team has done regarding performance. In areas with enemies and more simultaneous events, the new driver has a slight influence for a performance gain. However, in more open areas, the old driver still outperforms. So, if your goal is to play this game, it's advisable to test to see which driver is best for your device. In Tears of the Kingdom, I was also surprised by the significant reduction in stutters and even lower RAM consumption, although I can't accurately state the actual RAM savings. I noticed that near the end of the video, the interface showing the gameplay benchmark had frozen on the old driver, while on the new driver, there was still enough RAM for the app to continue running. I also observed an improvement in shadow rendering in the new driver, seeming that, with the old driver, some shadows were missing. Overall, the gain with the new driver is 34%. In conclusion, I'll make brief comments on other games tested where I didn't notice considerable gains. Astral Chain, no gain or correction of graphical issues was noticed. Pokemon Scarlet. Initially, the game wasn't running at 30 FPS in handheld mode, but now it's possible thanks to app updates, not driver updates. Regarding drivers, I couldn't notice any significant gains, but some bugs and tree leaves seemed to occur less with the new driver. Super Mario Odyssey. It performed better on the old driver, and graphical bugs in the grass haven't been fixed yet. Super Mario Wonder. It shows similar performance with both drivers. That's it for the video, folks. I recommend testing this new driver configuration on your devices, always using the latest version of the app available on GitHub. All necessary resources will be in the description. I hope you enjoyed the video, and until next time.